just avocado.
See?
Three avocados. Does anyone know avocado and chicken? Avocado.
I tighten up future tables.
Really?
Yeah, sure.
Jack of diamonds to 28k. Tom Vogelsong 3 bets it out of the small blind. Carol looks down at King Jack in the big blind. 4 bet from Charlie Carroll with the worst of it.
How are you gonna play?
I tighten up future tables.
Really?
Yeah, sure.
Instead, it's Carol taking it down with that 4 bet.
A ridiculously aggressive big blind.
But first, Tom wants to raise it up with the 7 deuce of clubs.
The pre-break.
Yo, let's go walk in the garden and have a hand history. So, it goes. Reg opens under the gun off 375k. He opens to 25k. Button calls his reg. Small blind, cash game reg calls. Cash game reg that bust us from the 25k last bullet. And we call the big blind with king queen. We would sometimes squeeze it based on live reads. It's a really nice hand to do it, blockers and whatnot. And we can just 3-bet get it in against the under the gun if we think that he's at the bottom of his range, because he might just be shoving like sixes or something. But we have a read that he's probably quite strong, so it'll be cool. The flop comes. King, queen, 9. For the flush draw, 2 hearts. We do not have a heart. And the small blind reg. The small blind reg leads out, snap leads out for like a quarter pot or something. The size might be wrong, but it's somewhere around there. We snap call, or like 5-second call. We want to keep our range pretty wide. But we can have like king deuce here, we can have some queen tens, stuff like that. Under the gun calls as well. So when the under the gun guy calls, we think his range is probably a lot of like ace, king, king, jack, aces. And we think and the button calls again. And we think his range is maybe like, and everyone can have jack 10. Everyone can have jack 10, which is dumb. Like I can have jack 10, everyone else can have jack 10. I can have 16 combos of jack 10, everyone else can only have 4 combos of jack 10. So we're in business here, range wise at least. Not feeling great. Because, you know, there's still 3 people that can have 4 combos of jack 10 suited. The turn comes an 8, and the small blind leads again for 175k. Actually, the undergun guy was deeper than I thought, because he now has about 400k left. So yeah, he was a bunch deeper than I thought. We cool, because not folding. He can have some 2 pairs that we beat. He can, which probably shouldn't be betting on this turn, which is the scary bit, because when everyone can have jack 10, some people can have sets, and everyone can have king, queen. King 9 and queen 9, which both suited, he'll probably call out the small blind. They're suddenly not beating that much, so I'm not happy about this, but I'm calling, because whatever. Under the gun folds, button tank folds. So we're like, under gun probably just had aces or ace king, which is like pretty relevant because, you know, we want a king and we're trying to range this guy, and it less likely has king nine because the under gun pretty much only has those two hands, maybe king jack and king 10. And I have no idea what the buttons folded at that at this point, because even king 10 for him should have folded the flop. The river is a brick five offsuit, five diamonds. And the small blind now leads bets for 450k. And at this point, I'm super not happy about it. Ranges are so narrow that he really should only be value betting, I think, like a set of nines if he doesn't squeeze pre, which he probably wouldn't. And watch if he did. A set of nines and jack 10, and maybe king queen. So I'm definitely not happy about it, but he looks nervous, pot odds, near the top of our range, whatever, cool. Not that the top of the range thing really matters. It's not like this spot's gonna come up again. And he has queen nine suited. Queen nine. And the undergun had aces and the button had king nine suited. It's crazy. So I don't think his play is good. I gave Ben a look afterwards and we were just like, okay. But whatever, everyone makes mistakes every now and again. But yeah, when ranges are so tight, queen nine suited is, it's like, it beats some hands that I have, like, you know, ace jack of hearts or something, but it doesn't beat the hands that I have that are getting to the river, which there's a bunch of two pairs and jack 10. So we're pretty happy about that result, pretty big pot. And I think this is probably the best main event in terms of how much fun I've had that I've ever played, just because everyone's chatty, everyone's pretty punty, playing some pretty ludicrous hands. People have calmed down a bit now on the feature table, which is a shame, and we have to be on the feature table again afterwards. I don't know why they're always putting me on the feature table. Maybe if I stop talking, then I'll appreciate it and just put me somewhere else. Back on the feature, yeah. They didn't keep the other people on for more than a level.
Because you and Ben are, who else is on there that's like big?
I don't know if it's because that we're big, but our whole table was talking throughout the first level and just like laughing.
Wait, so they brought chefs over and they just let them in the kitchen?
Cool.
Can we do that? Dude, let's just get like five of us and chop it. It can't be that
expensive. They're talking about flying chefs in? This is a life I want to lead.
How rich.
Say bye, dude. Just an avocado.
See?
Three avocados. Does anyone know avocado in Czech? Avocado.
Avocado.
Just want to eat them, not look at them, not smell them.
And everyone's mean, like, there's a Party Poker sponsored dude, and he's just like, so fucking funny and so lovely. So I think, yeah, he really adds to it. I like this. Man, going outside during the breaks makes me feel so much better. Having fun there? You made it, day two.
I got all the bags, guys. I need a signature and your chip count, please.
Ah.
Such a soft table.
So close. I made it. 25k away from 3 million.
Easy.
Easy table.
I'm on 2.975. What's the point? Why even turn up tomorrow? Yeah, I mean, fuck it. I'll just give it a go. This is just a disaster. This guy, though, first ever 10K, he's usually playing $100 buy-ins, 100 euro buy-ins, bluffs the super high roller, Mr. Broccoli, I mean Kale, and shows it with like half pot shove on the river, or like 2/3 pot shove on the river. Beautiful. Use the classic party poker pen that doesn't work. Here we go, boys. See you tomorrow. Dude, we had a good day.
Charlie Carroll will stack some more chips. Terrific day 1B so far for Carroll. Did you hear his order?
What?
Just 3 avocados.
Oh my goodness.
Jamie, huge avocado fan.
He's gonna eat 3 avocados.
That's what he asked for.
A lot of avocados. Sure.